And here they come. If you're on the waterfront, you need to look up round about now, I would say. Here they come. The flying barrel and his friend.
For us altogether, isn't it, now, with a high-pitched whistle of the jet engines, which of course superseded the piston engine aeroplanes, similar to the Invader from the Second World War, which we saw just now. These really were the next generation. Aircraft like this once held the world speed record.
Okay, so what we have in the lower aircraft as they pass in front of you is the Tunnan, the flying barrel, as it's known. This was one of the very first swept-wing aircraft. The Swedes needed to design an aircraft after the war. They built it around the de Havilland Ghost engine. And it says, this wonderful information, I said, it had a 25 degree wing sweep. But where and how this data was obtained is a mystery, since most German research papers were supposed to have gone to the UK or America. So no one quite knows how the Swedes got the information. We were chatting earlier on, I was chatting to Tony Harmsworth. And surely the Messerschmitt 262 was the first swept wing jet. But actually, that was started as a straight wing aircraft, and the wing was swept back to preserve the centre of gravity. So they
first shot down one of those German jet fighters.
He's called Peter Turley. And he was the tail gunner of a Lancaster bomber, a very, very brave man. And quite an achievement that he made. Peter, if you're listening, good afternoon to you. So these two aircraft flying in for tight formation there, up towards the cloud above Elizabeth Castle, and banking round nice and tight to the left, to head out towards the waterfront again.
Now the J-29 is being flown by Stellan Andersson, and the Saab 105 is being flown by Olli Norrin. Now, I think I pronounced that right, although I did apologise to them when I got their names in the briefing, because I said I'd probably almost certainly get it wrong.
Okay, so here these two aircraft come, left to right, good and fast here, nice and low.
Yes, absolutely, and you see now the 105 is moving off to the hole, and the Tunnan is coming back to do its display. This is also very unusual, because in the 1950s, the Swedish Air Force ranked as the fourth most powerful in the world. And the Tunnan is the only Swedish jet aircraft to see combat. In 1961, five J-29s were stationed in Congo as part of a UN peacekeeping mission. And no aircraft were lost, despite a lot of anti-aircraft guns, but the crews and foreign observers thought the Tunnan's capabilities were excellent.
It's certainly showing us its capabilities here today in the final formation, and then on its own here display above the crowds on this sunny Jersey.
Noise coming out of the back of that aircraft as it pulled up so sharply right above the waterfront, climbing very, very steeply right up in the heavens, and now here it comes down again, trailing on the station between the tips as it blasts down into Stirling's Bay, and then pulls up again very, very steeply above Elizabeth Castle. Really showing what it can do, Melvin.
It is. It's a wonderful little aeroplane. It's really good to see it. A total of 661 Tunnans were built from 1950 to 1956, making it the largest production run for any Saab aircraft. Of course, this was the forerunner of the Lancen, the Draken, the Viggen, and right up to the Saab, whose name I've forgotten.
Turns the noise of the jet flying.
other function and had beaten one commentator around the back of the head and reminded him that in fact it was the Saab Gripen that we should talk about, the current aircraft that owes its lineage to this very aeroplane.
Now I mentioned cameras there, just a reminder that if you get some good pictures of these aircraft, make sure you send them in to us at BBC Jersey, because our website will be covering this extensively and we want your pictures to put up there so that everybody else can see what happened in this display. Look at this, there's a photo opportunity, there that was.
Saab also managed to export this aircraft. They managed to sell 30 Tunnans to Austria in 1961, and they remained in service until 1972. So, a 20-odd year frontline service. And as we mentioned earlier on, the Tunnan held the world speed record for about a year in 1954, when it set the record at 977 kilometres an hour. And that record was eventually beaten by an F-86 Sabre, just like the model we were hoping to have here today, but unfortunately couldn't make it. Now passing in front of you, eventual version had afterburning engines giving it even more power.